How to buy a clown wig. If you want to look great as a clown, the right wig can make you look awesome, but the wrong wig can make you look horrible. I'm going to give you 5 tips to get the right wig and look great as a clown. We're going to talk about that right now. I'm going to give you 5 tips to make it easy to buy the right wig and then make it look great. Stick around to the end and I'm going to share the one mistake that will make you look horrible, like an amateur lipstick clown. And most first-time wig buyers make this mistake. Tip number 1, decide if you want to wear a wig at all. Until recently, almost every clown wore a wig. These days, many good-looking professional clowns choose not to wear a wig. As a clown, I wear a wig, but I do know the problems with them. Lots of clowns say that you should. You'll look better and more complete, but a lot of really great clowns are choosing not to wear a wig. Tip number 2, decide what kind of wig you want. When you buy a clown wig, don't just pick a color that goes with your costume. You also need to decide what style and what materials you want your wig to be. The majority of clown wigs are in one of these styles: afro, curly, straight, sometimes called silly boy, and bald pate. A few clowns use yarn wigs and look great, but unless you really know what you're doing, a yarn wig can really make you look like an amateur. Most wigs are made out of synthetic hair fibers. The other choice for wigs is yak hair. Yeah, that kind of yak. Yak hair wigs are nice because they can be washed, styled, and heat set, just like real hair because they're made out of animal hair. But yak hair wigs are very expensive and hard to find. At some point, you may want to invest in a yak wig, but don't get one for your very first clown wig. I want to know what kind of wig you wear. If you already have a clown wig or are thinking about buying one, please tell me what kind it is in the comments below. It'll be interesting to see what kind of wigs are the most popular. Tip number 3, buy from a reputable dealer. You should buy your clown wig from a dealer who specializes in clown costumes and makeup. Finding a discount wig online can be hit or miss. If you buy a wig from a dealer who is a clown, he or she will know what works and what will make you look good. And more importantly, you'll know you're getting what you really want. This is worth way more than saving a few pennies online. If you can, buy directly from a dealer at a convention or a conference. That allows you to see what you're getting and have all your questions answered. Tip number 4, how to make any wig look better. Most clown wigs come with extra long hair so you can trim it to look exactly like you want it to. You can wear them right out of the box, but almost all clown wigs will look better if you have them trimmed. And it's worth it to get it trimmed professionally. Unless you really know what you're doing, you can ruin your clown wig. I've found that a professional hairstylist can really make a clown wig look good. And most of the time, a professional hairstylist enjoys trimming a clown wig because it's a fun, silly change of pace. If you have a bald pate wig like I do, you can match the color to your makeup by taking whatever color makeup you use on your forehead and rubbing it into the bald pate. Rub it in really well and get the makeup into all of the fibers. Powder the wig just like you'd powder your makeup. Brush the excess powder off and repeat the process. The color stains the fabric fiber so it'll match your makeup. If the color begins to fade a bit over the years, you can repeat the process at any time to brighten it up. I'm going to give you my last tip and then that bonus on how to avoid looking bad. But before I do that, be sure to subscribe so that you can see lots of videos just like this one that will show you how to be a better performer. Tip number 5, take good care of your wig. Every time you take your clown wig off, put it on a wig head. This will keep it looking nice and tangled free for years, even decades. Wear a skull cap. Perspiration is the enemy of clown wigs. You'll sweat on hot summer days, but you'll even sweat in air-conditioned venues. A skull cap like this one can make your wig more comfortable to wear and absorb perspiration. You can throw the skull cap in the washing machine anytime it needs it. Wash and dry. You don't need to wash your wig after every gig, but over time you will need to. Wash it by hand in the sink with a gentle detergent or soap. Try not to twist or agitate the wig too much, as that will tangle it. Pat it dry with a towel and then let it air dry on your wig head. After the wig is completely dried, you can fluff it and gently brush it to give it a fresh, clean, styled look. Never use a curling iron on synthetic wig hair. That will melt the fibers. Bonus. Don't ever buy a rainbow afro wig. A rainbow afro wig screams amateur clown. I've known exactly one professional clown that has been able to pull off the rainbow afro wig and make it look good. They were super talented and their entire costume looked wonderful. Everyone else in a rainbow afro wig looks horrible. Beginners should not have to fight that uphill battle. So many knockoffs have been sold with cheap Halloween costumes that the public will think you look bad, and they may not even know why. Follow all five tips and you'll look great in your new clown wig. If this video helped you, hit that like button and be sure to subscribe and hit the bell notification so that you can see lots of videos created for performers just like you. And be sure to watch these videos that will help you be a better performer.